That way, that way, that way.
She's got that one.
Oh! That was awesome. Hey folks, Edgar B. Herwick III here from GBH's Curiosity Desk, where you ask questions and I find answers. It is a beautiful day at Paul Revere Landing Park, a very popular place for dogs in Charlestown, which seems as good a place as any for us to begin our quest to answer today's question. What exactly are the dog days of summer?
Is this like an old people saying?
It is an old people saying, yeah.
People who make like soprano references that I don't understand?
People from like the 1900s.
I have no clue. Bad weather? I don't know.
I don't know if it's a good term or a bad term. I would assume it's a good term, dog days. Happy days of summer. I'm literally picturing like an older grandpa sitting on his porch, like it's the dog days of summer or something like that. I don't know.
All growing up, it was like the latter part of the summer.
Dog days of summer, it sucks.
Yeah. That's...
Why do you think we call them the dog days?
You've been hot as heck all summer. You've been working your butt off.
Yeah.
And then the end of the summer comes and it's supposed to be cooling off. Now it's hot as heck again.
Dog meaning work to death.
Work to death, yeah, you gotta work the dog. That's what I'm thinking too.
Like a working dog, yeah.
Actually, the term has nothing to do with our furry four-legged friends, and it is not because it's peak hot dog season, though it is. In fact, the answer to our question is not to be found anywhere here on Earth, but rather up in the stars.
The dog days of summer, as we know them, are the hottest days of the year. But really what they are the days when Sirius, the brightest star in the sky, is visible.
That name, Sirius, comes from the Greek and translates to something like the scorcher. But it's just as well known by its longtime nickname, the dog star.
We call it the dog star because it's the brightest star in Canis Major, which means great dog in Latin. And the constellation, the ancients drew a picture of a dog because it actually in the sky follows Orion, which is the hunter. So it's kind of Orion's dog.
Sirius is indeed the brightest star in the sky, at least when it's actually visible. From early spring to late summer, the sun comes between us and the dog star, literally, and hides it from our view. But like clockwork, Sirius reappears each August, a moment called its heliacal rising.
And when it does that, it's going to be barely visible on the edge of the horizon. And every night, it will get a little higher and a little higher, and then it will start going down again and eventually disappear.
The dog star's annual arrival in the summer sky was a big deal for ancient stargazers of numerous cultures. The Egyptians connected it with the annual flooding of the Nile, and the Greeks thought the combination of the sun plus Sirius, the scorcher, was at least in part why the summer months were so hot and miserable. The ancient Romans also drew a link between Sirius and the sweltering summer weather during the dies caniculares, as they called them. From there, the concept spread to England, where everything from prayers to abstinence to a little extra bloodletting was advocated to counteract the supposed ills brought on by the annual dog days. Of course, today we know the dog star does not portend disease, and it has no impact whatsoever on the weather. Our summer heat is thanks largely to the fact that the northern hemisphere is tilted toward the sun during those months. Still, the concept of the dog days remains. Today, we officially celebrate them from July 3rd to August 11th. That is the 40 days leading up to Sirius's initial appearance in the summer sky. Oh, and speaking of that tilt in the Earth's axis, there is a small imperfection in it that is relevant to our story. It is responsible for something called precession.
Precession is something that most people know if you've ever played with a top. So if you spin a top, it spins really fast, but the handle of the top will make a gradual little circle that'll start getting wider and wider until it falls over. So the Earth kind of does the same thing, but it doesn't fall over. The axis of the Earth over a long period of time will make a little circle. So it will point to different stars, meaning the constellations will look different over different times of the precession.
Now we are talking 12,000 years here. So if we humans can somehow survive long enough, the dog days will fall smack dab in the middle of winter. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and perhaps most importantly, let me know what you are curious about, because hey, I might just look into it for you. I'm Edgar B. Herwick III. Stay curious out there.
When did you get this, Rob?
9:30,
and it is a couple hours old.
Less than
I mean, do you think that's gonna lead to food poisoning?
Yeah.